Okay, so now we have a Kaba-Ilko combination lock, common with load medium-tier security facilities such as data centers and whatnot. It's a keyless system, possibly. Sometimes they have keyed knobs on the outside for a backup. Completely mechanical combination lock, user resettable. And we're going to go over how to decode the combination of one of these if you have lost the combination. Obviously, you need some way to get inside the facility to take the lock off the door. And so we are going to start from that point there. So we're going to take the back off of the lock, so you're exposing the back and this, the brains of this lock. So we're going to take the cam off, and we've already removed two screws to remove the brains out of the lock. Now, this particular model, this is a 6200 series Simplex. There is a small E-clip there holding it together. So we're going to take that off, and be very careful when you're doing this, because these clips will shoot off into outer space and you will never see them again. Okay, put that off to the side. And now we just pull the housing off, like so. Exposing the guts of this lock. Now, this is really cool how these things work. Every time you press a button, you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, each button is directly connected to a geared wheel, similar to those in the cheap master lock combination locks. That geared wheel is directly meshed with this geared wheel, which is directly meshed with this bar. Now, this bar has teeth in it as well. It's curved on the interior, you know, kind of back behind there. And so when you push this button, this wheel turns, that wheel turns, which now activates this bar, which turns all wheels that have been activated. Once you press a button, that wheel will be activated for the entire duration of your combination attempt. So when you push one button, that wheel turns, it interacts with this. You push the second button, you know, that wheel turns, and then it also advances the first button one gear, or one tooth. When you press the third button, it advances not only that button, but it advances all other previously engaged wheels one tooth. So that's how it requires the combination to be put in the correct order. Now, the way the locking mechanism works is on these geared wheels, each one of them has a flat spot. Now, number 5 is close enough to show. As you can see, the flat spot here has been milled out, and this whole black piece here is your sidebar. And as you can tell, there's a little dog leg right there that fits very nicely into that flat spot. And so the goal is for all the buttons to be pressed in the right order, such that when they're all rotated, which means, you know, don't forget, whenever you rotate one, you've rotated all of the other previously engaged ones by one wheel. When all of them are rotated to the point that the flat spots are all sticking straight up, you know, from this orientation. So I guess they're sticking out to the side, but irrelevant which direction. They're all going to be facing straight up like that. So how do you decode these things? Well, I'm glad you asked. It's very easy. So each wheel only has one flat spot. We're going to call the true gate. And so what you're going to do is you're going to turn the lock to the side. You may have to shine a light down in there. And you probably won't be able to see that, but you're going to find the flat spot on each one of these wheels. All right. So now, you know, pretending that this is, you know, north from this direction, you can tell that wheel number 5 is kind of out here, kind of directly northeast. And wheel number 4, it's kind of hard to see, it's pretty much directly east. Wheel number 3 looks like southeast. Wheel number 2 looks like east-southeast. And wheel number 1 looks like east-northeast. So you're going to find the wheel that would need to travel the most amount of distance to reach 0 degrees. So which wheel is facing the most, you know, the furthest east of north? In that example, or this particular instance, it is wheel number 3, because it's facing like all the way down here. So we're going to push that one first, because that one's going to have to travel the most. All right, so now let's do it again. Which one has to travel the most now? And it looks like it's number 2, because number 2, so yeah, number 3 was like way down here at southeast. Well, wheel number 2 is kind of in between, so east, southeast. So now we're going to press that one. Now, while I press that, you can see that not only will the second wheel move, but the third one will move as well. Oh, that was the third one. Okay, so yeah, let me press the right button this time. I don't know if you saw that, but that wheel moved and number 3 moved, because it's already been engaged. So let's do it again. Which one needs to be turned now? Okay, so now number 5 is sticking up this direction. Number 4 is sticking out this direction. Number 1 is kind of cocked off to the side like that. So number 4 needs to be turned now. So now let me push number 4, and you'll see all those buttons move. It's kind of subtle, but you saw 2, 3, and 4 move together. But now I can tell I'm in the right order, because you can see the edges of the flat spots on 2, 3, and 4, and see how they're all lined up. That means those wheels have been pressed in the correct order, and they're just riding the wave for the rest of the combination. So now we got 1 and 5. Who needs to travel the furthest? Looks like number 1 does. So let's press number 1. Alright, so now you can see that 1, 2, 3, and 4, they're all lined up. But now number 5 needs to be pressed, because now it needs to travel. And I push number 5 and all the wheels turned. And then let's try to open the lock. Boom, lock's open. So that's the process of decoding the combination. Now, it is possible that more than one wheel needs to be moved at the same time. These mechanical locks, you can have the combination be only 4 numbers, and maybe the 5th one isn't used at all, or maybe the 2nd one isn't used at all, and the way to identify that is when the lock has been reset, one of the wheels will always or already have the flat spot lined up. When the flat spot is already lined up, that means that that button is not used at all in the combination. So, also, when you have determined which wheel needs to be rotated the most, if it looks like 2 of them are lined up with each other, it's possible that both of those need to be pressed at the same time, instead of, let's say that 1 and 2 both had to be rotated the furthest. Well, I can't press 1 and then 2. It doesn't work like that. I would have to actually press 1 and 2 together, so they both rotate in unison. So that's how that works. And there could be 2 buttons pressed at the same time. There could be 3 buttons pressed at the same time, 4, even all 5 buttons pressed at the same time. I don't know why someone would have a combination like that, but it is mechanically possible. So that's all there is to it. Find the flat spots. Find out which ones have to be rotated the most to reach the 0 degree mark. And whichever ones have to be rotated the most, that's the one that needs to be pressed next. And so you're working your combination from number 1 to the last number. And that's really all there is to it. There's no special tools you need. You just need to identify an angle and eyeball which angle is greater than the other. Now, it could be subtle between one wheel or the other. But, you know, surely the combination isn't that close to one another. So there may be a couple of attempts and trial and error trying to determine which of the two wheels need to be rotated first, if they're real close to one another. But, you know, within 1 to 3 shots, you should have this lock decoded. And once you have the correct combination, you can reassemble the lock and go through the combination change procedure, and you're good to go. And that's all there is to decoding a Kaba Simplex lock.